A lot of legal situations are depicted both in movies and in television. Some of it's real, some of it's not. But as a trial attorney, it's hard for us to watch it and not think, yeah, that could happen, or completely far-fetched. So we're going to take a look at one of my favorite movies of all time, My Cousin Vinny, to see what's accurate and what's not.
Ms. Vito, please answer the question. Does the defense's case hold water?
No. The defense is wrong.
Are you sure?
I'm positive.
How could you be so sure?
Because there is no way that these tire marks were made by a 64 Buick Skylark. These marks were made by a 1963 Pontiac Tempest. The car that made these two equal-length tire marks had positive traction. Can't make those marks without positive traction, which was not available on the 64 Buick Skylark.
And why not? What is positive traction?
It's a limited slip differential, which distributes power equally to both the right and left tires. The 64 Skylark had a regular differential, which anyone who's been stuck in the mud in Alabama knows. You step on the gas, one tire spins, the other tire does nothing.
That's right.
Now, in the 60s, there were only two other cars made in America that had positive traction and independent rear suspension and enough power to make these marks. One was the Corvette, which could never be confused with the Buick Skylark. The other had the same body length, height, width, weight, wheel base, and wheel track as the 64 Skylark, and that was the 1963 Pontiac Tempest.
And because both cars were made by GM, were both cars available in metallic mint green paint?
They were.
Thank you, Ms. Vito. No more questions. Thank you very, very much. You've been a lovely, lovely witness.
First off, you gotta give credit to Marissa Tomei, one of the greatest characters in the history of cinema. Right here, I think she won an Oscar for this performance. It was phenomenal. Now, whether or not this is in fact accurate, well, let's look first at expert witnesses. Yes, expert witnesses are used quite often in cases, both criminal cases and civil cases, to help explain certain things to the jury. Her testimony itself, in a normal context, should have laid a little bit more of a foundation. He's just handing her photographs. He's just hearing what her opinions are without actually laying a foundation to what those opinions are. But what she says and how she goes about doing it, pretty accurate. I mean, that's how they would talk about the specifics of a case. They would look at the data. They would talk about the positive traction and all those types of things. I've had experts that I wanted to kiss because they've done such an amazing job on the stand in presenting our client's case to the jury, but I don't think, one, that would be permitted, and two, that it would be wise, because you don't want the jury to think that this particular witness has any bias for or against you. The expert witness is there not as a representative of the plaintiff or the defendant or the prosecution. They're there really to give an independent opinion. Now, it would be the plaintiff or the defendant who's hired that expert, but that expert is there really to give an independent opinion based on their own expertise. So as much as you may want to hug and kiss the expert because the testimony was so good for your case, wouldn't be allowed, and probably not necessarily smart to show the jury the relationship you have with them. Pretty good performance, probably not 100% accurate, but one of the greatest legal movies of all time, My Cousin Vinny. If you like what you see, be sure to like, comment, and subscribe for more Trial Lawyers React.